Everybody, life is weird. Wait till I tell you this. I'm walking home from the show. I was going to do a video earlier today to talk about the super fans of Be More Chill, which we close tomorrow. These kids that found the soundtrack, the recording of the show, I keep saying soundtrack, how dare I, cast recording from the original run and fell in love with it flash forward, really arguably the reason the show made it all the way to Broadway. And they've been, they're insane fans, these kids, these teens. They do fan art, they send gifts to the theater, mostly to the cast, but they've also found us on the crew who are on social media, like myself, and have been super sweet and generous and insane, really, with their praise of us and everything. So anyways, that got me to thinking about a million years ago at Beauty and the Beast, there was a woman, Naomi, who would come over from Japan at least three times a year, maybe four times a year, and only see Beauty and the Beast three or four or five times in a row before going back to Japan. Sweet Japanese woman. And every time she came, Naomi would bring like treats, little candies and things for everybody in the company, and be at the stage door every day to get autographs, every day. And these treats and candy, Japanese things, they're very ornately wrapped little gifts. They're just astounding. Once you unwrap it and you get to the actual treat, it's like stuff made of like bean paste. Ugh, that's their idea of treats. Anyway, somebody in the cast once had one of them up in the dressing room and said to me like, oh, I got some candy from Naomi. Do you want some? And all I did was look at him and say, why? I didn't do anything wrong. Because that's kind of the way it felt when they gave you candy. Anyways, flash forward, Beauty and the Beast closes. I end up at Phantom of the Opera about a year or so later. And I'm minding my own and I'm leaving the stage door one day at Phantom of the Opera. There's Naomi. She switched from Beauty and the Beast to Phantom of the Opera. And started seeing that like two or three or four times a year, five or so times in a row. Crazy. With candy. I think she likes the shows with the tortured leading man with the ugly face. So anyways, I was going to tell you that story today. Flash forward to today. I just left the theater. I'm walking down through the neighborhood. I go past the stage door of Phantom where I see my friend Jeremy Stahl. Oh, he's doing a show at 54 Below next Sunday. We should all go see it. And I see him at the stage door and I'm going to say hello. And I look next to him. There's Naomi getting his autograph and giving him treats. So I had to go and say, Naomi? She was thrilled to see me. I haven't seen this woman in years. And when I first tell you I met her at Beauty and the Beast, that's at least 15 or 16 or 17 years ago. And she's still showing up here to see Phantom. Fans, Broadway matters to so many people. It's really moving when I think about that. And these kids again on Be More Chill, they're heartbroken that we're closing. And I did a video on Instagram because that's what they don't look at these videos. This is for us older people. They look at my Instagrams and I just left them a message saying, thank you for all your support. And guys, although you don't believe it now, you will fall in love with a different show. You will fall in love again. Go listen to a cast recording from something that was recorded before you were born. Like all musicals, find other things and keep doing your fan art, but do it for yourself and do it for others and just do your art. So what we do in our little theater, sometimes it's easy to forget how much that matters to so many people in so many ways. And I just walked away with a lot of bean paste treats from Naomi. So I'm gonna go home and possibly eat them. Oh, bye.